In the previous videos, we have seen that the voltage spikes or ringing voltage gets induced on the drain of the MOSFET, which is due to the reflected voltage and transformer's leakage inductance. We saw the significance of a snubber circuit in averting these high voltages from MOSFET's drain, which can harm the MOSFET switch. We understood the operation of RCD-based snubber circuit as well as we saw the design of the snubber circuit. After that, we also understood the operation and placement of RCD-based snubber circuit in the flyback converter. RCD-based snubber suffers from some drawbacks though. At times, when the voltage on the MOSFET's drain is not very high, then also the RCD-based snubber will conduct and some amount of energy will be lost in the resistor of the snubber. Hence, RCD-based snubbers will always conduct even if there is no requirement and will reduce the efficiency of the converter. Let us say we have a safety margin of 30% for the 700 volt maximum rated MOSFET that is internal to the tiny switch. Then the maximum tolerable voltage on the drain of the MOSFET will be about 535 volts. Now let us say that the line voltage at a moment in time is the normal 230 volts, which amounts to 325 volt DC link voltage, and the voltage spike about DC link voltage is 200 volt, which includes reflected voltage and voltage spikes due to leakage inductance. The total stress on the drain of the MOSFET will be 525 volts. These voltages are well below the safety margin of 535 volt. So we do not need any snubber operation at this point because the voltage on the MOSFET is less than the permissible value. But if we implement an RCD-based snubber, then it will dissipate some energy in the resistor and will contribute to the reduced efficiency, which is undesirable. For this reason, it is better to go for a TVS diode-based snubber circuit if one desires a better efficiency. We will look into the operation of TVS diode-based snubber circuit, but before that, let us understand the operation of TVS diode. A TVS diode, which is short for transient voltage suppressor diode, is placed in parallel to the device that is to be protected from transients, be it switching transients or lightning transients. The TVS diode can clamp transients due to its inherent characteristics. When the voltage across the TVS diode is less than diode's reverse standoff voltage, the diode won't conduct. Its leakage current is in terms of microamperes, which makes it insignificant in this region. When overvoltage is imposed on the TVS diode due to switching transients or lightning transients, the TVS diode enters into breakdown region and its current starts to rise. Hence, the diode provides an alternative low impedance path for the overvoltages and absorbs the transient energy to keep the protecting devices safe. The TVS diode provides many performance advantages. As compared to RCD-based snubbers, a TVS diode can give faster response. The low breakdown and clamping voltages relative to its reverse standoff voltage, transients can be clamped quicker to the normal operating voltage when compared to RCD snubbers. So this much will be for today's video. In the next video, we are going to look into the design of a snubber circuit based on TVS diodes. The design will also include selecting a proper value of blocking diode. Thanks for watching. Drop a like if you found this video helpful. Leave a comment if you have any query regarding the topic. And don't forget to subscribe and share this video with others.